Thank you very much for joining us today in this room. I'm now very happy to introduce Pablo Herrero de la Venae. He's the head of business development at Vizrt, or I could also say Vizrt, in Europe, Near East, and Africa. Just very quickly, we have talked a lot about interaction with readers, viewers, users. That is absolutely key these times. What does Vizrt do precisely, and why is it so compelling?
Well, we are a technology company. We are a software company, and what we do is we have tools for the journalist to build the stories and to publish the stories as fast as possible, but always with a very important identity and brand of the company behind. So we have customers from many years like BBC or Al Jazeera or Fox. But we also have newspapers like Expressen or Parisien or even Cheddar, people like that. Mm-hmm.
If you talk about speed, how fast can stories be brought up on the net?
It has to be. I mean, honestly, if you are the second one, you are already a loser. So you have to be the first one. Mm-hmm. But it has to be done with all the things we've been talking now. I mean, when you prepare a story, it has to be. A trusted story. It has to be certified. You have to do your
trusted
job as a journalist.
Mm-hmm.
But that doesn't mean that so you need to do it everything very fast. And if you use what we've been using on talking about video, what we've been using on TV the last 30 years, that's too heavy and too slow. Mm-hmm. So, but at the end, whatever you publish on your website or on your mobile, it has to be good quality. If it's not good quality, users will simply escape it.
You have a facility called VizStory, yeah, that you offer to people. If people use this kind of gadgets, is it most of the time one person teams that they do it all on their own?
No, it's always there's always an organization behind. Mm-hmm. So the person who wants to tell the story is always the journalist. He's the owner of the story, and he's the only one who can really do it. But it works for a brand. Or for multiple brands. Mm-hmm. Actually, you work for an organization who has probably multiple outputs. Mm-hmm. BBC One, BBC Two, BBC World. Mm-hmm. But they are still you are still a journalist from BBC. So your story is probably valid for all of them. But you have to dress it, and you have to put the identity of all of those brands without even thinking. And it has to be super fast on doing this. But at the end, if the interview is the interview.
One thing is speed, the other thing is storytelling. For example, in Germany we have the Tagesschau, which you call a show, yeah, a real show, really related to old standards of storytelling. If we are talking Viz, can you tell us a bit more about the way of storytelling, how that can be revolutionary for people sitting here in the room?
Yeah, if we follow the TV rules, then we're going to end doing a 30-minute show in ZDF or in R&D. And that's not really what is happening on your phone or on your web. Things that happens on your phone are story related, and it happens when they appear. So you cannot really wait to have half an hour to do your show. Mm-hmm. So the idea is that you can really work immediately anywhere, no matter if you are in the Starbucks or at home or in your facility, access your content and access your identity. And then we also believe that the user should not know the technical things behind. He should just do his story in two clicks, publish it and brand it and distribute it. And that's the job for the back-end guys. That's the guys.
Your target groups, are they mainly young people or across all ages
no.
of people who are consuming the content?
No, not at all. I mean, actually, that's the thing. I mean, we believe that it has to be simple for the non-expert people. Mm-hmm. So that means people who has been working for 30 years, but people who just arrived. So because at the end, what you have to produce is, it's a different storytelling, like you say. So whatever goes to the internet is not really what goes to the Tagesschau. So Tagesschau is 3 minutes, internet maybe is 1.5.
Is that long, 1.5 already?
It depends on the quality. If it's good, I mean, it could be even longer. If it's a good thing, you will keep on watching it.
Yesterday we talked about that we should not talk about multimedia anymore. Content is content, be it video or be it podcast, be it whatever.
Absolutely.
Is that your
I think so
opinion?
Too. Yeah. It has to mean multimedia. It's an old word. Mm-hmm. And I think everything is already multi-output. So you need to work always thinking on if you have a story, you have a story for your text, for your Facebook, for your Twitter, for your web, for all those multiple outputs that you have to deal with them.
If you want to know more, please go to Vizrt, to the stand in the middle of the back where you find the climbing wall.
Next to the coffee.
Yeah, next to the coffee.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for sharing your insights. Elena, she's also part, if you want to get into details on Vizrt. In 40 countries, they are already.